Today we're going to look at a slightly different bit of custom PC hardware today. We're going retro. This is the RC2014 Mini. This is a modular Z80 based computer system. The RC2014 Mini itself comprises of this small board on the base here. This in itself comprises all the parts you'll actually need for a computer system. It has the processor, it has the memory, it has the ROM. On the ROM is a basic monitor and an interpreted basic. Being modular, if you wish to expand the computer system, you can plug it into a backplane. Now there are a number of different backplanes available, but this particular one has 5 slots. We have the processor board plugging into slot 1, the slot 2 is currently empty, and in the top slot here in slot 5, we have another set of memory and another set of ROMs. This particular ROMs contains both BASIC and CPM. CPM is a disk operating system. It was very popular in the late 70s and early 80s, and was used for a very large number of computer systems. As an example of this, here is a UK home computer from that period. The New Brain, with an integral keyboard and a one-line display, it could also be plugged into a TV or monitor. This system was also Z80 based and had 32K of memory with BASIC on ROM, and was capable of being expanded to a full CPM system via the expansion bus. With 2 serial ports and 2 cassette tape input outputs, the computer was fairly well equipped for its time. The aluminium edge where these outputs were located was actually a passive heatsink which extended into the centre of the case. With this ROM board plugged in here, we then gain access to the complete CPM system. And in addition, the middle board here is actually our graphics card. This graphics card has 2 purposes. It first of all gives us a VGA output at the side here, which we can plug into any VGA monitor. And in addition, it has a USB slot into which we can plug our keyboard. So we have everything in here with the exception of storage. I'm saving the last slot for a storage card. You may ask where this particular computer system draws its power from. The power in this case comes from this serial cable, which is in fact a USB cable. So this entire computer system can be powered off a USB cable. Since I plug this into a VGA monitor, my monitor itself has USB slots, and I use this to power the entire system. The current draw of the system is very minimal. It can quite happily be run off a USB power bank. Although this unit has no storage, you can plug this USB cable into a normal computer and use this to download programs from your PC. The Z80 processor in this kit runs at a leisurely 7.3 MHz. And is capable of addressing 64 kilobytes of memory directly. So why would you want to take a nostalgia trip into computing history, even with the most successful 8-bit processor ever made? Well, all the components are new, and the board designs are both new and compact. Additionally, there are a growing number of add-on boards coming out, designed by makers, so there will always be something to build, even if that means you need to dust off your old soldering iron. Its operating system is in ROM, so it's not going to get wiped or corrupted, and any updates made to it will be entirely under your control. If you want to swap out the 7.3 MHz processor for a faster model, you can do that. There will be no other programs cluttering up your computer's memory or grabbing system resource. It's not going to run Call of Duty, but there are a lot of Z80 games and other software out there. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this look at a retro system. Thank you for watching.